All right, so let's talk about how to use the equation triangle to rearrange equations easily. Now, if you're good at rearranging equations, if you don't have any problems with that at all, you don't need this step. Skip this step, skip the equation square, and go straight on to just using the mnemonics to help you remember the equations and running through the practice questions. That's absolutely fine. But if you ever have any problems rearranging equations, then the equation triangle, the equation square, wonderful ways to do it. So let's look at the equation triangle and let's pick an equation. First one off the top of my head, force equals mass times acceleration. F equals ma. Force, mass, acceleration. Now, in the mnemonic, we have force equals acceleration times mass. Exactly the same. Okay, so let's look at that then. Force, acceleration, mass. F equals ma. Suppose I want to find the mass. I've got some information given to me in the question, probably the force and the acceleration. I'm asked to find the value for the mass of the object. Well, the traditional way of doing it is I would write F equals ma, force equals mass times acceleration. Then I would divide both sides by whatever's multiplying through the mass. So that would be the acceleration. I would take force over acceleration on the left-hand side, and that would be equal to mass times acceleration divided by acceleration. And of course, acceleration divided by acceleration equals 1. So that would then give me force over acceleration equals mass. Similarly, if I wanted to calculate the acceleration and I had values for the force and the mass, then it would be a simple case of following the same procedure. Force equals acceleration times mass. I would want to divide both sides by the mass at that point. That would give me force divided by mass equals acceleration times mass divided by mass, which would then give me force over mass equals acceleration. And of course, I already have the equation to get the force. The force equals mass times acceleration, or acceleration times mass. Okay, so what I can do is I can put this information, this equation, into a triangle. I put the force at the top of the triangle, and I put acceleration times mass in the bottom of the triangle. And through the center of the triangle, I just put a line. Okay, now that I've taken the equation, force equals acceleration times mass, and placed it into this triangle in this way, whatever I want to find, I just cover over, and what's left tells me the equation I need to use. So if I want to find acceleration, cover it over. I cover over acceleration, and what I'm left with is force divided by mass. If I want to find the mass, I cover it over, and what I'm left with is force divided by acceleration. If I want to find the force, then all I do is cover it over, and what I'm left with is acceleration times mass. So that solved my problem. I don't need to worry about running through the stages. I just put everything into the triangle format. So what if it's slightly longer? What if I have something like gravitational potential energy? GPE equals mass times gravity times height, MGH. It's exactly the same thing. GPE goes at the top, gravitational potential energy goes at the top, and mass times gravity times height goes at the bottom. If I want gravity, I just cover it over. It's a gravitational potential energy divided by the mass times the height. Any of those things, any of those parts of that equation can be covered over, and what you're left with is the equation that you need to use to find the values. So when you're doing the questions, there's a little sketch on the side, put in the triangle, cover over the bit you want, and what you're left with is what you need to write down. Because a lot of times for these questions, there's marks for the working out. So if I'm doing F equals ma, I want to find the mass, then I would cover over the mass, it's force divided by acceleration. I would write down two things. I would write F equals ma, and I would write m equals F over a. And that's very important. Make sure you're showing your working out, you're showing the equations that you're using to get the answers. There we go. Good job.